And welcome back. So, the next step on this diesel house is to get the track in. Now, I've got this Walthers Flex track. I measured it. I thought it was 36, but they're actually 39. And so, I should be able to, the little Marcus here, I should be able to put it in and get two pieces from one piece of flex. So I'll have one extra piece left over after I make the cuts. So the plan is to have a little sticking out on each side. I may put a little bit more to one end. This is what I deem the front of the building. It's taller here. And eventually down on this end in a full layout, I would have a transfer table here. Which I have the kit for, not built. But for this, I haven't decided if it'll be a complete through or there'll just be a small section of track on the backside with like stoppers or something. Anyways, I'm going to attempt to cut with these really old snippers and see if I get a clean cut, clean them up with the file, and I'll tell you a little what I think is going to be a tip to getting this track in there. Because the Walthers track, I've also spray painted it, so it's a little crunchy. But the Walthers track maintains its bends versus like an Atlas, which will bounce back to its original shape. So we'll get to that in a second. I'm going to cut this and get all three pieces, and then we'll move on from there. Alright, so that went pretty easy. These are probably older than I am, but one thing, cutting the first couple of rails was a little difficult, but I actually just used a file on it to clean it up, and the second one clipped so much easier. A couple things about these. When you're cutting rail with a nipper like this, you can see how there's this beveled edge and then the flat face. The clean side of the rail that you want to use the flat side. So, and be sure to cut it like straight up and down as possible. The first time it took me a few tries. After I sharpened it, it went through pretty easy. And then I just used my couple of files just to clean it up. You want to make sure that the inside edge is clean so that the wheel flanges don't catch. And just sort of like the top edge so that you don't cause any derailments. Because once this thing is in, it's going to be a lot harder to clean up. Now, I did put all the cut ends to the back of the building here. So all the factory cut ends are kind of here at the front. I haven't quite decided how much track I want to leave at the front versus the back. I figured if there is a transfer table here, there should be a little bit of space. So it'd probably be like some sort of, I don't know, maybe like a concrete walkway or like a path so that the construction workers can either drive vehicles. I don't want the transfer table like right up against it. So, and then there's a little bit left here on the back side where you can either put a bumper or I can extend the track back and then the engines can, it can just be through. That's ultimately what I would like, but it's all going to depend on space. So the next thing we have to do is take out the ties to get them in. But I'm actually going to recommend that you don't take out all the ties, because if you do, the rails are going to be really difficult to line up. So what I'm going to try to do is take out the rails for these flat sections. Sorry, take out the ties, and then take out the ties in the middle as well, but I'm going to leave a couple here and there. Just enough to fit, maybe just even a single, every couple, to fit between the supports here. So that way, I'm hoping, in addition with a track gauge, that these rails will be close enough. Yeah, so we don't want to glue it down yet, because obviously we still have to wire it, but we need to get all the ties out so that we can test fit and go from there, because I also need to mark on the bottom where the wire is going to go. So I'm going to start doing that and I'll be back. Okay, we can see here that I've left every few ties in just to help hold it in place, and then very carefully I wiggled them so that they weren't sort of blocking any of the supports, just due to these little tabs on there. I had a couple of them that I couldn't push all the way down. Anyways, it's, you know, obviously I haven't glued this, I haven't wired it, but so it's a little springy. And I did just test it. This old junky car, I can't believe it has horn hooks on it. Anyways, sorry, this isn't, never works the way you want it to. There we are. All right. Yay. Rolling stock, isn't that fun? Okay, anyways. So now, the step, don't throw this away, by the way. This will come in good as filler on your layout, or, you know, whatever the case may be. But even if you just trim it down, you could use them for prop and scenery. So don't throw it away. Just be really careful, because if you push down on them, at least on this Walther one, they pop off really easy. And once they pop off, they don't really want to go back on. They will, but it's not great. It's not the same as it was. So in the last episode, we drilled holes underneath here, and that's where we're going to put our wire. And so let's talk about wiring for a real quick second. A couple here that are already stripped. Now, my soldering iron's not on yet, but let's just talk a little bit about what rail is what. So I did some research, because I really didn't have any idea on what I should do for, you know, red versus black. And I read about the right-hand rule. So if you're, I think I got this right, if you're sitting in a cab, the locomotive, the engineer is always on the right. So that's right hand. And so the positive rail, the red, should be on the right hand. And if this building, the front is this way, hypothetically the locomotives would be coming out of it. We could argue this a thousand different ways. Basically, I'm gonna make the rail closest to me, the red one. And then when I get all three wired and glued down, I'm gonna link them together, and they're gonna become part of a power district that is the maintenance facility. So that's what I'm doing. That's the right-hand rule. I think with any rule, it's sort of, as long as you pick a rule and stick to it, then you'll be fine. But for me, red is positive, right-hand rule, it's the right rail, the one closest to me, because we're going that way. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to, the holes are here, so I need to solder this really tightly between the edge here and this support. So that should be pretty interesting for me to try to get this done and still have it fit, but I'm gonna give it a go and we'll see what we get. So I don't know if you'll be able to see this. Let me see if I can get it to focus right there. But right here, where my solder joint is underneath, the solder joint has bulged a little bit. So what I'm gonna do, I'm glad I tested on one. I'm gonna pull it back out just a little tiny bit and try to sand it down a little and see see if that'll work. All right, it's in pretty good, good enough, I guess. So I'm going to use my trusty super glue and a toothpick. And I'm gonna start at the front and work my way back. It's kind of a pain because now I've got it perfect and I've got to pull it up to put glue down. But I'm gonna start this end and work my way down, sort of a couple at a time. Once I get this section in, I'm gonna clamp it. I tested that this fits without crushing any of the base, and it's rising up just a little bit here, and I want it to like stay down as much as possible. And it's really due to the way that I drilled the wires. So I drilled through this way, which also the little posts were kind of in the way, so that was a pain. The next ones, the holes are up a little bit higher, so maybe that'll be easier. But honestly, it means the wire is soldered on this way, goes down, and then so it kind of makes like a Z shape. And it probably would have just been a lot easier to go straight down. So if you're building this, just a little word to the wise, it might be easier to go straight down. I was trying to be probably a little overzealous on hiding the wires, and I mean, they're pretty well hidden, but you know, you could either hide them with scenery or you probably wouldn't even notice. So have it be a little easier on yourself and just go straight down. So that didn't happen at all like I expected it to. I kind of just ran with it. This end down here where the solder was, I actually couldn't even pull it up. So what I did was I always squirt my super glue out on a piece of blue tape, and I used a toothpick and just like scooped up like a bunch, and then slid it under, and then pulled back in the slot where the walkway is. And then I used the toothpick to just, I slid it under the rail. And then I realized I couldn't really glue some and not the others because it would be really difficult. So I basically just, as quickly as possible, went through and tried to glue the whole thing. Now, this end down here was a lot easier because the track was able to come out. So I was able to take my toothpick, covered in glue, and slide it along the little indentations for the rail. Now, because I went so fast, I have no idea if this track is in gauge. So I'm gonna go find my little microengineering track gauge and see what we get. Okay, it has been about 3 or 4 minutes. I've noticed, and I'm not sure why, this rail over here is not like it's a good 3 or 4 millimeters up. Not really sure why it's doing that or why the glue didn't take. So it's kind of a bummer. Anyways, I may just use the toothpick or the super glue bottle and literally just go down and try to get it. Anyways, I have this micro engineering light. Come on, there. Micro engineering code 83 track gauge. So let's open up this bad boy. This will be lost after this first use, I can tell. Okay, so it's got little grooves in it. There's two that are in two that are in series and one parallel. So we're gonna put this on like so and just test it a couple of places. I think it's magnetic. Nope. So We are out of gauge. Where are we? Oh. Maybe my little trick worked. Yeah, it looks like we're pretty much in gauge. Okay, we'll test with this little junkery here. Doesn't seem to be any problem. We need to get this track down. So I'm going to try to figure out what's going on with this. And trying to get this down in a little more level. And then we will continue on. So I have this little clamp. Can't remember if I got it off of Micromark or Amazon, but it's sort of a hobby size C-clamp. I tried using these clamps a little farther down, but they're just too strong and want to distort the rail. So they kind of only work up in where it's flat here. Took a couple of these ties off just to try to see if maybe they were the one causing it, but ultimately the little supports themselves, they've got these ridges and they run parallel, but if you don't have them perfectly sanded, and it may even help to have a spare piece of rail kicking around that doesn't have any ties on it, just to have, because I'm looking at some of these other ones and they turn just a little tiny bit, maybe one will go this way and one will go this way, but the little lip, I think it's the little lip that's causing the problem, because they're almost impossible to get perfectly straight. So anyways, I'm just letting this dry. I have gone back and slathered super glue into all these because I want it to stay. Once the walls are up, there's really, like, it'd be impossible to try to go in and fix it. I'd have to tear the whole building apart, which the amount of super glue and plastic cement that the walls and stuff will have, it'll be a lost cause. So, anywho, just due diligence now, so hopefully save us headaches later. Yeah, I couldn't leave well enough alone. I've actually never used this engine since I got it. I haven't even tested it, so this is kind of the test. Hooked it up to this old Tech 2 Railmaster 2400. This is still DC. I actually have no DCC equipment at the moment. So fire it up and it clearly needs to be cleaned, but it looks like it's she's a little rusty, but she'll do. Once I get the engine cleaned up, or the motor cleaned up and a DCC inside of it, hopefully it'll be better. Anyways, it worked. So I've got the other ones, all the ties are out, so it's definitely going to be a pain to try to get this middle one glued down, but I'm going to do my best and go from there. Okay, soldering tip one, have a good soldering iron. This thing is 20 years old, and for the most part, it does the job, but it is so slow to heat, and I don't know. I think it's time for something, a little bit of an upgrade that's a little more professional, because it's a total pain to work with. It takes forever. And I'm always paranoid, like with the electronics, that I have to apply the heat for so long that it's going to actually damage the components. So, anyways, do yourself a favor. Go out and, I don't know what the wattage on this is. I don't know if it says. This is a Radio Shack. 25 watts. Get yourself at least 40 to 70 watts. It'll heat up really quickly, and you know, if you can even get one of the ones that has the variable temperature, that's even better. So I'll add it to my upgrade list. As I fight with this track too, I thought of something that might even be easier than trying to, and would completely hide the wires. So there are these grooves here on for the track. If you had like a Dremel, I mean, I suppose you could do it manually, but it would be a huge pain in the butt. But if you had a rotary disc that would fit between these, you could carve a slot here, and it would give you more surface area to make your solder connection. It would completely hide it, and you wouldn't be dealing with the freaking headache I'm dealing with now trying to get this to work, in addition to trying to get it to fit. I knocked off like 3 or 4 of the ties in the middle. I knocked off the end. The ties, the rails were going this way and that way, and everything's not as easy as it should be. And I've caused that because I need to make everything complicated. So just a tip that, yeah, if you went down through the slot, you could make a pretty decent size hole under the rail, and that would provide you plenty of surface. And with gluing and everything, it just would be so much easier than what I'm doing. So, little tip, if I had a Dremel, I would be doing that on probably these 4 rails, but I don't. And I can't think of a way that to do it. I guess I could do it with a drill, very carefully make a whole bunch of holes, and then use the file to do it. So maybe I'll try that. Well, that was so much easier. Okay, so I have the other one from here, because the one from here still has its wires on. Anyways, I took a 1/32nd bit. I don't know, it exactly fits in the rail slot. And I drilled, let's see if you can see this. I drilled 4 consecutive holes. Used my X-Acto to kind of break the pieces in between, and then put the file in and just filed until it worked. So I should be able to very easily, and there's plenty of wiggle room. I might even do some more. Plenty of wiggle room here. Might even do some additional sanding just to widen it up a little bit. But that gives me a lot more flexibility in solder space. And I'm not worried about height if it goes over onto these supports, which was the problem down here. So hopefully, looking at the back of this, just clean this up and go from there. Cool. Yeah, right. That's enough for one night. I'm exhausted. But that method worked so much better than this, and the wires are 100% hidden. I did scuff the paint just a smidge, but I honestly don't care. This all needed to be weathered anyways. And I broke off one little track support, which I already re-glued back on. So these track ties keep falling off. I may have to glue them on, because I don't know if the little tabs are broken now. Because if they are, they'll never stay on. Anyways, I'll come back and glue these tracks tomorrow morning, assuming the cat doesn't destroy this overnight. So, anyways, see you on the flip side. Last track here. It's gluing down. I've got the clamps on each side. It's definitely easier to do than the middle track, which is a complete pain in the butt. However, it wasn't so bad once I got the holes for the wires in this section versus in the little tabs. The thing that is a pain is trying to, even though the track's tight and I've got it clamped down, it still bows a little bit. This track on this side facing me, I did a better job of keeping the rail ties on, unlike the middle one, which I broke a lot off when I was flailing around, and I still have to try to get new ties on this end. I may just end up super gluing them to the bottom. So yeah, that's about it. I definitely recommend, if you build this model, to drill your wire holes through here. And it may actually be easier, even though it's not in the order of operations for the instructions, to put the rails in and the little support piece in before you do the platforms. I'm not 100% sure, because I found that they were just kind of in the way, at least on the middle ones. Maybe if you left one off and did one, I don't know. This is definitely a challenging kit to put together, partly because there are so many pieces, and you know, now I've got stuff sticking out of the bottom plate, and now there's rails sticking off the ends, and I just feel like it's going to become easier and easier to smash. So I think I'm going to call that a wrap for this video. The only thing I'm going to do next is, once this is all dry, I'm going to flip it over and I'm going to get the three red wires soldered together and three black wires soldered together with one pigtail lead off of that, so it can just be powered together. And then from there, I just have to put in the ramps and the guides. Sorry, can't speak right now. The railing needs probably another coat of paint. Who's to say? It looks good on some sides, but I think it needs another spray. So get those railings in, but I want to make sure that I do everything I need to do on the bottom side first, because I can rest it on the platforms. But once I put the railings in, that is done. Done and over with. And then I need to think about the wires that'll come up for the lighting, and what I may try to do for the walls, who's to say, is to put up one, like two walls, the front wall and the side wall, just so I can start to think about wiring, because it's really hard for me to envision right now. And I think once I get one wall up, I will be able to wrap that around my head. I still haven't decided on what to do for the window grills. I like the idea of a contrasting color, but I'm still not in love with the default gray that the plastic is molded in. So, don't know what to do yet, but the online consensus seems to be leave it that gray. I personally don't love it, but I'm still thinking about it. Alright, so until next time, I will talk to you guys later.